What's going on, everybody? I'm Jory Goodman, the time teller. So depending on when you're watching this, tomorrow is my birthday, June 12th. I'm turning 29. I'm getting old, but I bought myself a little birthday present, okay? And I think you're gonna be really interested in this because it's making me rethink all my G-Shocks. Introducing my Seiko Prospex Fieldmaster SBEP-003, AKA the Digi Tuna. It's 1:32 p.m. Let's get down to business. So this thing's got a 200 meter water resistance rating. It's got a 49.5 millimeter case. It's 14 millimeters thick. It's got a 44 city dual time zone. It's got your alarms, it's got your chronograph, and it's pre-programmed all the way to 2067. So this solar powered Fieldmaster is definitely one tough cookie. I mean, just looking at it, it screams tactical, rugged, and the spec sheet I just went over is impressive, but there's some really cool features about this watch that you might not notice until you get your hands on one. So first, when you look at the dial, you'll notice the negative display. Some people don't really like that because they say it's hard to read and the contrast is never quite right. Well, this thing has actually got an adjustable contrast setting, and that's pretty cool because my G-Shocks don't even have that. So the next thing I want to address is the rotating bezel, okay? I first made a video talking about the release of these watches, and people were asking me constantly in the comment section, how the heck does a digital watch have a rotating bezel? How are you supposed to use it? Well, you actually use it just like you would on any other analog watch with a rotating bezel. You'll notice on the inner, I guess, chapter ring on this watch, you'll see some increasing hash marks. And those are actually indicating minutes as they go by. So you're gonna take the pip and you're going to align it to the most recent hash mark. And as time goes on, it will show you how many minutes have elapsed. So it's a very, very cool feature. And again, you'd use it just like you would on any other analog watch. Another really cool feature about this watch that you might not notice until you get your hands on one is the backlight, okay? This watch does have a negative display. And as we all know from various G-Shocks and other digital watches, negative displays don't really do well in low light situations. They're not the easiest to read. So backlights really do help. And when you first take one out of the box, you may be a bit confused because you'll notice none of the buttons turn the backlight on. So what the heck, how do you actuate it? Well, you actually take your finger and you tap the crystal and the backlight will turn on for 2 seconds. Really, really interesting feature. And it kind of confused me. Why did they choose to do that? Kind of weird. Well, the more I thought about it, the more it started to make sense. When you're in a low light situation and you can't see anything, do you really want to be fumbling around for the buttons? No, why not just hit the watch and have the backlight turn on? So pretty convenient and pretty thoughtful. Another really cool thing about that feature is that you can actually go into the menu and change the sensitivity. So if you wanna really hit it hard or you wanna just lightly tap it, you can change it to fit whatever you want. Now the watch came on this black silicone rubbery strap, which honestly feels pretty good, but I quickly, like immediately switched it out for this olive drab sailcloth strap, super rugged. And I think it honestly fits the watch much better. It kind of gives it that rugged, outdoorsy look that I wanted. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take off my SBBN 031 Tuna and put on the Digi Tuna. Now I know a lot of people are really turned off by that 49.5 millimeter case because on paper it does sound huge, I know, but there's something about tunas that make them wear much smaller and much more comfortably. And I'm telling you guys, this does not wear like a 49.5 millimeter watch. It wears much smaller. I'm a big dude. I have 7.5 inch wrists and I think it looks amazing on my wrist. So, okay, does this watch really justify getting rid of all the G-Shocks? Well, here's what I'll say. So every video that I make mentioning G-Shocks and how much I love them, I get a lot of people writing to me telling me they're not really into G-Shocks. And I get it. A lot of the designs are kind of prominent, kind of almost obtrusive. And I think this Fieldmaster is the exact opposite. I think it's very sleek, very flat, and it just lays on your wrist perfectly. Definitely not obtrusive. Also, as I mentioned earlier, changing straps is much easier with this watch than it is on any G-Shock. I mean, this has drilled lugs, uses normal spring bars, just fits in perfectly. You don't have to hassle with adapters for NATO straps or any of that junk. Right out the box, you can customize it, make it your own. Another thing I'll say is that Seiko Tunas tend to be kind of expensive. My SBBN 031, this is about a $1,300 watch. Sometimes it goes above that. Sometimes if you're lucky, you can find it a little bit below that. But if you're looking for a Tuna, a really impressive watch, but you don't want to break the bank, I think this SBEP-003 is a really, really good option coming in right around $300. So am I honestly gonna throw out all of my G-Shocks because of this Digi Tuna? Well, I don't know, man. For really extreme environments, I think G-Shocks are hard to beat, and I've grown up with G-Shocks and I really do love them. So I'll probably end up keeping my G-Shocks, but this Digi Tuna is a really, really slick, really, really fun alternative. And for a Seiko guy like myself, I think this checks a lot of boxes. And again, I know a lot of you aren't necessarily into G-Shocks, so take a look at these Digi Tunas and maybe this will check a lot of boxes for you too. But let me know what you think, guys. I'm gonna come back in a few more weeks when I've spent a bit more time with this watch, give you a few more comments, a few more insights about it. Maybe I found some more things I like and some more things I hate, but so far, I'm just in love with this watch. All right, guys, well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this Monday episode. I hope the rest of your Monday is amazing, and I hope the rest of your week is amazing. I'm gonna go out to dinner and celebrate my birthday a little early, but yeah, tomorrow I'm 29! And I wanna thank you so much for checking out the Time Teller Shop. Guys, it really does help the channel out a ton. Click the link in the description below, shop around. You'll find some of my favorite watches and watch accessories there. So again, thank you so much for that. And if this is your first time joining us here at the Time Teller channel, I wanna say welcome. Thank you for tuning in. Why don't you join the party? Click the subscribe button. It takes 1 second, helps me out a ton. And while you're at it, go ahead, click that little bell icon so you do not miss an episode of the Time Teller. There's just so much more awesome content on the way and you don't wanna miss it. I'm telling you guys, please like, comment, and subscribe. Share this with other watch enthusiasts, other people that you think would enjoy this. I'm Jory Goodman, the Time Teller, and always remember, I didn't invent time, I just tell it.